Do all of that, and the Honda K24 can be an incredibly reliable engine that can easily make it to... Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common Honda K24 engine problems and reliability. The Honda K24 engine began production in 2001 and remains in production to this very day in a limited number of models, but during its now nearly 25-year production run, the K24 has powered dozens of different Honda and Acura models and also has dozens of different variants, even more when you start factoring in the different power levels of some variants and updates that were made throughout the years. Now, Honda is undoubtedly known for building some very reliable and successful engines, and the Honda K24 is no exception here. The K24 is a very reliable engine, and that's a large reason why Honda has kept it around so long. But despite its excellent reliability, the K24 still is prone to a few issues that are more common than others. So with that said, let's go ahead and dive straight in and discuss some of the most common problems with the Honda K24. Number one on the list, we have front main seal oil leaks. The front main seal is also known as the front crankshaft seal, and it's responsible for sealing the crankshaft to the timing cover. Now, this is a very basic rubber seal, and over time, that seal is known to wear down and begin cracking and developing leaks from the front of the crankshaft around that timing cover area. These issues most often develop on the K24 in the ballpark of about 100,000 to 150,000 miles. So generally not something that happens very early on in the K24's life, but outside of mileage, age can be just as hard on any rubber or rubber-like materials like the front crankshaft seal. So some of the most common symptoms here are going to be a visible oil leak, low oil levels, and potentially burning oil smells or smoke from the engine bay. Now, as a relatively simple oil leak, this isn't an urgent repair, but it's definitely still good to get it fixed sooner than later, especially because over time, those cracks will continue developing and getting larger, and that oil leak will continue getting worse. When it comes to replacing the front main seal, the seal is relatively inexpensive. You can pick those up for about $10 to $30. However, it can be a somewhat labor-intensive job, so if you end up at a repair shop for this, you can end up spending roughly $300 to $600 to replace that front crankshaft seal. One other thing to mention is, here I'm highlighting the front crankshaft seal. However, really on any older internal combustion engine, there are a lot of rubber or rubber-like gaskets, hoses, O-ring seals, etc. And all of those can become more common as vehicles continue aging. So this isn't the only potential oil or coolant leak from the K24, but the front crankshaft seal is certainly one of the most common oil leaks on this engine. Moving on to the second common problem, we have cam lobe galling. Cam lobes are responsible for controlling the valve lift, and galling of the exhaust cam lobes on the K24 is a well-known and well-documented issue. Really, this just boils down to excessive friction on those cam lobes, which can ultimately cause that galling and wear on the cam lobes. This can be an issue that affects just about any variant or version of the Honda K24 engine. However, exhaust cam lobe galling does appear most common on the K24 A1 as well as the K24 A4. Now, when it comes to some common causes, is oil that's too thin, a poor oil change history, or just poor oil quality in general. So make sure you stay up to date on oil changes, use quality oils, and a lot of the times this won't be an issue. Again, it's a relatively small percentage of vehicles that are affected. But if you do run into issues with the exhaust cam lobes galling, then the most common symptoms are really just going to be a clicking or ticking-like sound from underneath the valve cover area. And you may also start experiencing power loss, especially once that galling gets severe enough and can actually start affecting the lift of the valves. So a couple symptoms to be on the lookout for there. This can be a relatively expensive repair job since it does require replacing the camshaft. So this job can run into the $1,000 to $1,500 ballpark if you end up at a repair shop for this job. And when it comes to DIYing it, replacing a cam is a pretty experienced level job, so definitely not something to try unless you're an experienced DIYer. But to highlight once more again, this is a relatively uncommon problem, just something that tends to be a bit more common than some other issues with the K24. Moving on to our third and final issue, we have timing chain tensioner issues. Prior to the Honda K-series engines, Honda had primarily used timing belts rather than timing chains. The major benefit of timing chains is they have much longer service intervals and can often last the lifetime of the engine without needing any kind of maintenance or replacement. However, on many vehicles with timing chain systems, one of the weak points can be the timing chain tensioners. And in the case of the Honda K24, the specific issue lies within the timing chain tensioner and a spring within there that can cause the tensioner to fail. This is a problem that predominantly affects earlier model K24 engines, since again, the timing chain designs and systems were still a little bit newer to Honda at that time. In the recent years, especially looking at newer Honda K24 engines, the timing chain tensioner can be an issue, but a lot less common, so something to be aware of there if you are looking for an older engine. Otherwise, the timing chain design is actually very robust and a good design overall. Timing chain tensioner failure is still a relatively uncommon issue that affects a pretty small percentage of K24 engines. So with that said, kind of in summary of these common issues we discussed and tying that into overall reliability of the Honda K24 engine, sometimes talking about the most common problems on an engine can paint kind of a dreary picture and make you think the worst. However, that's really not true with the K24. This is a very reliable engine. Pretty much any internal combustion engine, as it continues aging, is going to be prone to its fair share of common problems. Finally, many of these issues I discussed, including the front crankshaft seal oil leaks, the cam lobe galling, as well as the timing chain tensioner issues, a lot of these problems don't start popping up until 8 to 12 plus years old. In 100,000+ miles, so it really doesn't boil down to any true design flaws, just natural wear and tear that any internal combustion engine is exposed to. All that being said, when it comes to the Honda K24, just as is the case with any other engine, maintain it well, use quality fluids, stay on top of oil changes, and fix and replace any issues when and if they do occur. Do all of that, and the Honda K24 can be an incredibly reliable engine that can easily make it to 200,000+ miles with very few issues along the way. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.